Okay, this is the last problem from lecture notes 4.10 in AP Calculus, and we are on our second day of related rates. This problem says water is going into a trough at a rate of 10 cubic meters per minute. Let's figure out what that is. That says d something dt is equal to 10 cubic meters per minute. Since it's cubic meters, I can tell they're telling me about the volume of something. And actually, that makes sense. The water is going in 10 cubic meters per minute. So they've given us dv dt. How fast is the water level rising when the water is 2 meters deep? So you can see the water in this trough. This is like a horse's trough that the cowboy would bring his horse up to get a drink. And we're going to call this depth right there h. If the trough was all the way full, it would be 4 high. So h is probably something less than 4. And as a matter of fact, at this one certain time they're asking about us, h is 2. And they're asking me how fast is the water level rising. So they want to know how fast that h is changing. And so I would say dh dt equals question mark. That's what they want to know. Since the water level is rising, I'm expecting a positive answer because the height is getting bigger and the water is rising. Okay, so there's basically, we've actually finished one step of this problem, just pulling all the information that's given out of the problem. But we have two other main steps. The first thing, and the hardest thing by far on this problem, is get a formula. There has to be a formula somewhere involving volume and height. And then the second part of this problem is take a derivative and plug in. Plug in, okay? And that will be the easy part. But getting the formula is where we really need to work at for a little bit. So this take a derivative and plug in, piece of cake compared to this part. So first we need to think about the volume of this shape and just what kind of shape that even is. It's not a sphere, it's not a cylinder. In general, in geometry, we call a shape like this a prism. In your geometry book, they usually stood them up on end, so it would have looked something like this, just so you can relate to how you saw it before. And they called that a prism, okay? And that's actually what it is, a prism. And notice that it has two bases that are the same, and then it has this height. According to this picture, the height would be 16 if we stood it up on end. No horse is gonna drink out of it like this, though, but the height is gonna be 16. And the volume formula for any prism is the area of its base times the height. We already know that the height is 16. And for the area of the base, that's what B stands for, is area of the base. In this guy, I should use lowercase b, in this guy, that area is going to be a trapezoid. So we'll take a little bit and work on the area of that trapezoid. Because that's the part that we need. This height is 16. It's the height of the whole prism. Okay, so I'm going to move over here and just think about only the base, just getting the area of the base. Okay, so here's just our base, just that trapezoid. If the trapezoid was always full, finding its area would be pretty easy. This is supposed to be even. Not looking very even to me, but just pretend, okay? It's supposed to be even. The bottom is 4, the top is 6, the height was given to be 4, and I like drawing it in right over here. This is 4. If I drew it on this side, it would also be 4. Okay. And it's supposed to be even on both sides. It's an isosceles trapezoid, and so that means that since it's 4 down here, it would also be 4 up here, and that would leave, to evenly divide that 6, a 1 and a 1. So that would be 4, 1, and 1. But if we wanted the area of the whole thing, if the trough was totally filled with water, then the area when full would be 1 half base 1 plus base 2 times the height of this base. Okay. When it's full, that would be 1 half base 1 would be 4, base 2 would be 6, and the height, when it's all the way full, would be 4. Okay. And we could work that out. 10 times 4 is 40, half of that is 20. That's good when it's full, but it's not all the way full. Okay, so when not full, what things will still be the same? The half will still be the same. That's the area formula. The bottom base will still be the bottom base. But what happens when this is only filled up to here is that the top base right up here will be shorter than 6. So we need to figure something out for that. And the height will be shorter than the whole 4. So we'll need to figure something out for that. So I would like to put H right here for the height, just that height that I want, just this height of the water. Okay. And so I don't have anything for this spot, I don't have anything for that height. Actually, I think I'll put H in, because H is one of the variables I wanted according to my given information. So I have this so far. So I'm gonna have to spend a little bit of time working out what that top base would be. Now if you think about it for a little bit, going across the middle section will still be 4. But what's going to be shorter is these two pieces on the end. There's not going to be one and one left for them. And there will be something less than that. And it kind of depends on how high the water is. The closer to the top, the closer to 1 those are. The closer to the bottom, the closer to 0 those are. And so we need to make some kind of variable expression for how long that is based upon how high it is. So right now I'm going to put R in those two spots. And so this top base, this base 2, would be 4 plus 2 R's. And I could put that right in that spot right there, 4 plus 2 R's, that's my top base. But then I would have R's in this problem, and I really only want, let's look, V's and H's. That's the only things I really want. So I don't really want to have that R that I artificially made. So look briefly at just this piece. Just this piece right here, I have that this is H, and I have this little piece is R. Down here is where my water is. I had that this whole height was 4, and this whole way across at the top was 1. So I know that as the water fills up, the ratio between the height and the little R is still going to be 4:1 as you go up. Similar triangles. By cross multiplying, I know that H is 4R, and I don't want to put in R's there, I want to put H's, so really H over 4 is equal to R. Alright, so here's what my top base was. Another version of that would be 2 times H over 4, which could be H over 2, and that's what's going to go into this spot. 4 plus h over 2. 4 for the base 1, and 4 plus h over 2 for base 2. And then times this height. So there is our lovely area of the base. I think we are finally ready to write a volume formula because we have an area of the base. It's not very neat. So we probably are going to want to do a little cleaning up. I'll start with it like this. 4 plus 4 is 8 plus h over 2 times h. And then that was all for base. So for height, remember that we had 16. So there's so many things to distribute into this parentheses. I think I'll start by putting those three things together out there. 1/2 of 16 is 8 with an h, and then I have 8 plus h over 2. And then to distribute that in, I will end up with my volume equaling 64h plus 8 reduces with 2 to be 4h squared. All that work, and we finally have a volume formula. That's what we were looking for. That should be the formula you actually can use on your homework. So on this homework problem, the most important thing to me is not you working for the formula. The important thing for me is once you have a formula, do you know how to find the rate of change in the water level? And how to find that is take a derivative and plug in. So we're going to take the derivative of this volume formula, and that will give me dv dt, because we're taking the derivative with respect to time. And the derivative of 64h is 64 dh dt. And the derivative of 4h squared is 8h dh dt. And then we're just going to plug in. Dv dt was 10. It was gaining 10 cubic meters per minute because it was filling up. Dh dt is the thing we don't know. 8h was 2. I'm putting in a 2 right there, so 8 times 2 gave me 16 dh dt's. And I could add the 64 and 16 up, and I would have 80 dh dt's. And then when I divide by 80, I will have 1/8 is my dHdt. And if we think about that in terms of the units, I would say that is 1/8. What unit am I using? Meters of a meter per, what time am I using? Minutes. So 1/8 of a meter per minute is how the height is changing. Because it's a positive, I know it's going up. 1/8 of a meter per minute. And that should be very similar to your number 37 that you have to do on the homework. So good luck.